The U.S. Surgeon General, Dr. Vivek Murthy, is appealing to the nation to fight misinformation about COVID-19 and vaccines. At the White House today, he charged that bogus online claims are feeding vaccine resistance, and he said social media companies must do more.
We are asking them to step up. We know they have taken some steps to address misinformation, but much, much more has to be done, and we can't wait longer for them to take aggressive action because it's costing people their lives.
Also today, Los Angeles County, California ordered everyone, even the vaccinated, to resume wearing masks indoors as infections spike. And the head of the World Health Organization pressed China to stop withholding raw data on the origins of COVID-19. He also said it may have been premature to rule out that the virus escaped from a Chinese government lab. A major effort to address child poverty in America has begun. Millions of parents today received initial monthly payments averaging $420. It is a one-year expansion of the child tax credit under President Biden's pandemic relief plan. We'll talk with Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen about this and more after the news summary. The United States will not be sending large numbers of troops to Haiti. Haitian officials had requested a U.S. force after the country's president was assassinated. But President Biden rejected it today. He spoke at a joint news conference with German Chancellor Angela Merkel at the White House.
Thank you all. We're only sending American Marines to our embassy to make sure that they are secure and nothing is out of whack at all. But the idea of sending American forces into Haiti is not on the agenda at this moment.
As Chancellor Merkel was in Washington, her country faced a flood disaster. More than 60 people have died after record rainfall sent rivers pouring across western Germany and Belgium. Torrents swept through towns, leaving whole neighborhoods in ruins. People had to be airlifted from rooftops, and more than 200,000 people, or rather homes, lost power. In the western U.S., firefighters spent another day battling dozens of wildfires. One in southern Oregon covers an area larger than New York City. It has burned 21 homes and threatens nearly 2,000 more. And in eastern Washington state, forecasters issued a day-long warning for extreme winds that could whip flames into firestorms. Cuba's president has partially acknowledged that government failings fuel protests over food shortages, power cuts, and communist rule. Miguel Diaz-Canel spoke in a televised address last night. He called for careful analysis of Cuba's problems, but warned against any violence. Back in this country, President Biden's nominee to run Immigration and Customs Enforcement promised a new way of doing business. Sheriff Ed Gonzalez of Harris County, Texas, has criticized ICE policies under President Trump. He told a Senate hearing today that he would uphold the rule of law and insist on humane treatment of migrants.
It's important that ICE does not work in a manner that in any way intentionally just seeks to terrorize communities or anything of the sort. I think it's important for us to be a professional agency that could take care of it's done effectively.
In the past, Gonzalez opposed a voluntary program of local cooperation with federal deportation efforts. Today, he said he would not seek to end that program. A jury in Annapolis, Maryland, has found that a gunman who killed five people at a newspaper office was criminally responsible. Jared Ramos pleaded guilty to the 2018 attack at the Capitol Gazette, but contended that he was not sane. Today's verdict means that he will go to prison and not to a mental health facility. The Biden administration announced rewards of up to $10 million today to fight ransomware attacks on critical U.S. infrastructure. The effort seeks to identify hackers linked to foreign governments. President Biden has already warned Russia over harboring ransomware gangs. And on Wall Street, the Dow Jones Industrial Average gained 53 points to close at 34,987. The NASDAQ fell 101 points. The S&P 500 slipped 14. Still to come on the NewsHour, why a top leader in the military feared that former President Trump was laying the groundwork for a coup. The pandemic's disparate impacts on the cost of living nationwide. how childcare for military families could be a model for the rest of the country, and much more.
This is the PBS NewsHour from WETA Studios in Washington, and in the West from the Walter Cronkite School of Journalism at Arizona State University.